Tinkery. To survive against the horde of immortal minions, they actually must punch them through the shared borders into another clear screen, thus shifting the pressure onto the
other. Our dynamic split screen also supports its natural form of rubber banding. Due to the fact that as players take damage, their screen borders move closer to them. This shorter distance means it's way easier for you to get minions out of your screen, so players who might have made mistakes earlier on have a chance to get back in the game. Another effect of this dynamic split screen is the fact that the areas in which you can get minions out of your screen is going to be always changing, so players need to be aware of where everyone has their screen aligned in the environment. So here we have a player that's being ganged up on by the top two, but they're adapting their strategy to use their environment defensively. As the top two players attempt to bombard them with minions, they'll quickly move themselves in the environment to block those borders with the buildings that make it up. And then for offensive players, like the top two, they can move to more open areas and then punch minions at each other in quick succession. So balancing these strategies of keeping your borders guarded while also minions out of your screen is really important to a player's survival.
And here you can take a look at the top-down view of our map. We've designed it to facilitate these strategies like the ones you just saw. Also in the environment are three of Grimaldi's demonic carnal towers that offer players another way to interact with each other. So a tower is charged by punching minions into it, or by punching it directly. Punching it minions into the tower charges a lot more, since it's more difficult and more rewarding. Once the tower is fully charged, players choose which opponent to use it on. Unless they've made their selection, the effect activates. What you see here is a rage ability, where all the minions in that player's environment will swarm at them, try to knock them out real quick. This is a great way to have knock other players down a peg if they've gained a big lead, or to knock someone out of the game.
So yeah, now that we showed you all the parts that make up your Grimaldi, we're going to switch over to a quick live demo so you can see it all. We have our four people up here. It's going to play. We made the game in Unity. Plug Unity real quick. There it is, too. That's proof. Character select screen where everyone can join in. We added a slight amount of character customization too. Our controllers work. They don't work. We just got that new Xbox One novel. It's been really nice to us so far, except for right now. There we go. One person. So as you can see, you can change your skin color, you can change your shirt color. It also tints our environments a bit, different parts of it, like the roofs will tint, there's different foliage parts that will tint, like flowers and things, parts of the ground. So yeah, we're going to jump in on a little mode. The three people, environment tinting, and this it, so that people where they are on the screens. After a countdown, people are going to move through their environment, get a bearing on where they are, deal with their first minions that they find. We ramp up the difficulty so that... And we're out of time.
So...
That was fun. We'll take any questions that you guys have since our presentation was so good.
What kind of power-ups or balance the gameplay so two people can get a gameplay from one person? How do you make sure that people are going to take advantage of balance in your game?
Did balance of the level design, depending on where you are on the screen, did you consider that in the level design? So that if there's one section of the level that might be more advantageous if you're in like the top right of the screen versus not?
That's a good question. So all of the environments are actually mirrored, so everyone's actually in the same map. That way it's an even playing field. We didn't want one person just have a natural advantage over someone else. One of the things when we designed the map layout was the density of the buildings, as you saw. So although it may be advantageous for someone to be in a closely populated area, makes it a lot harder for players to punch enemies in, it also really kind of boxes you into that layout. So someone, say, uses a rage tower on you, it really puts a lot of pressure and can kind of bite you if you don't actually keep track of what everyone else is doing.
Obviously, were there any assets that you used that you didn't yourself create and you didn't see there? And also, what was your development time?
So we started development in September, so we've been working for about 6.5 months. The only asset that is currently in there that we didn't custom create is a Unity standard asset, Fire. And we added it very recently. Our fire particle effects in the environment, they're Unity standard assets, but they will be changed quickly as we move into development in the coming months.
Other questions? All right. Thank you, Drexel University.